Count me out, I'm counting my, I'm loading my, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. Real ones been dying, the fake ones are lit. Game is off balance, I'm back on my, the Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all of my. I'm all in my bag,
as hard as it get. I do not snort powder, I might take a sip. I might hit the blunt, but I'm liable to trip. I ain't popping no pill, but you do as you wish. I roll with some fiends, I love them to death. I got a few mil, but not all of them rich. What good is the bread if my niggas is broke? What good is first class if my niggas can't sit? That's my next mission, that's why I can't quit. Just like LeBron, get my niggas more chips. Just put the Rollie right back on my wrist. This watch came from Drizzy, he gave me a gift. Back when the rap game was praying like this. To act like two legends cannot coexist. But I never beef with a nigga for nothing. If I smoke a rapper, it's gon' be legit. It won't be for clout, it won't be for fame. It won't be cause my shit ain't selling the same. It won't be to sell you my latest little sneakers. It won't be cause some niggas slid in my lane. Everything grows, it's destined to change. I love you little niggas, I'm glad that you came. I hope that you scrape every dollar you came. I hope you know money won't erase the pain. To the OGs, I'm thinking you now. Was watching you when you was paving the ground. I copied your cadence, I mirrored your style. I studied the greats, I'm the greatest right now. Fuck if you feel me, you ain't got a choice. I ain't do no promo, still made all that noise. This shit gon' be different, I set my intentions. I promise to slap all that hate out your voice. Niggas been counting me out. I'm counting my bullets. I'm loading my clips. I'm writing their names.
Yo, what's up, guys? Delaney Wallace, aka Strongest Accountant Alive. This is episode 9 on the road to Sheffield. We are officially like 26, 27 days out from Sheffield. Super excited. They actually sent us a nice little kit with some stuff in there. I'll show you that a little bit later. But you know what time it is. Got a nice bench workout, one of my heavy bench workouts. See if we can hit something nice. You know what to do. Tight nutrition, about to take the pre-workout. Hit the QR code, go support me. It means the world. And let's get going.
I usually wait till after I warm up to get this bar, but it's cold as shit, so I need to let this shit warm up a little bit. This thing is freezing. I need to move to Texas like everybody else where it's warm out.
Funny enough, a lot of my clients, not a lot, but a couple of them were talking about like shoulder pain. Actually, some of them some elbow pain when they were like benching or squatting. And from my PT, Justin, which y'all saw in an earlier episode, if you didn't see it, go check it out, right? A lot of it that I found was lat tightness and shoulder tightness. And so what I found that really helped me out was this rolling out my lat and just sitting on it like for like 10 seconds in like three different spots that hurt. And then a different shoulder kind of stress that I'll show you guys later really opens me up. Every squat session, every bench session, I've just been doing these like one or two like quick things, quick bands, and I'm under the bar and I'm all good to go. And it's really helped loosen me up, allowed me to be in low bar and not get that elbow tendonitis that I used to get, open up my shoulders, and really help me on bench as well. So yeah, if you're getting like shoulder pain or like elbow pain, usually the elbow pain is coming from tight shoulders or tight lats. So like these two things will knock it out. Give it a couple months, a month, a couple weeks, month or so. It is tight. And then here's the shoulder one. Really is simple. Just put your hands a little under shoulder widths. You know, roll out, middle, one to the side, hold for 5 seconds, one to the other side, hold for 5 seconds. Do that 4 times each side, hold for 5 seconds each one, and you're done. Good to go. Single on bench today. I actually have a top double on bench today. That's all right. Still gonna blow something big up. I was hoping for a single though. Get to go super heavy. We'll see. We'll see how it goes. I don't feel like my arch is that big, and I sometimes get off the bench and I'm like, damn, my back hurts.
This ain't natural. Shit. I'm getting old. I usually don't like putting the chips on, but just for today, I want to be like super, not super accurate, but I want to be pretty close to where I want to be so I can know what kind of jump I want to make for this top single. So slightly different, but I usually try to stay away from the chips. You can't go up 2.5, don't go up at all. On fucking hitting the rack. Damn. The only thing that sucked is like, if like I don't get to go to Worlds this year, then I can't qualify for Sheffield next year. Then I'm out of the whole thing. So it was like that whole balance thing. I would have to go in there with the intention that I'll probably have to go hard. Cause I mean like Gruden, he's already totaled like 817.5 or something like that, which isn't too far from the Carpino.
I think he hit like 805.
Yeah, he ended up hitting 805. So he didn't have the best day. But like, you don't expect somebody not to have a good day.
Yeah, exactly.
Like I was expecting
it's
him to
expect the best day.
Exactly. So I was gonna expect him to hit like 830, 835, 840 maybe. Which means that I would also have to push, and then I'd have to push again for Sheffield.
Yeah, it's like,
and so I was just like, you wanna know what? Like I'm just gonna roll the dice. Like I hope nobody hits the Carpino. If they do, then I just have to ball out and try to get an alternate spot. But it's like, hey, like Sheffield's a once in a lifetime opportunity. Like, there's no guarantee that I ever come back again. So, you know, I rolled the dice. It rolled in my favor this time. Now I get my turn to like respond and try to get my world spot back and, you know, hopefully have a good go around this time. So, hey, it worked out. I just put it in God's hands. I was like, it worked out. But it took me a while to come to peace with that decision. You know, because like in my head, I'm like, fuck, like.
It's risky, like at the end of
it. It's risky,
it's
yeah.
Risky both ways.
Yeah, you know. I would regret going to PA Nats, getting hurt, or just fucking up my peak for Sheffield more than I would regret going to Sheffield, balling out, and missing Worlds, and just having to.
Exactly.
Yeah, like, I miss Worlds, then I'll do the fucking Cayman Islands thing, or I'll just wait till 2024, and I'll just like, hey, have a whole year to train. You know, the prep from Nationals to Worlds last year, it wasn't too fun. I mean, it wasn't terrible because we didn't have to like really ball out at Nats, but like it wasn't fun having to do that water cut twice. For some reason, you know what it is? I was super, super busy with work last year.
Yeah.
And I didn't have the luxury of like readjusting things to fit powerlifting in. So I was just like, I was just sitting on the desk all day. Like, the only movement I had all day was, yeah, nothing. I mean, I was legitimately getting in some days under 1,000 steps the entire day. Like, the entire day. And so, like, my weight just was just higher than it's ever been going into, like, those preps. Because I'll usually sit, you know, around, like, 190. I was, like, 194.
Oh, shit.
Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't get down to, like, 191 until, like, 2 weeks out. Just hit a top double at 4:30. It was supposed to be like an 8. Hit the rack, some things happened. Turned probably into like a 9-ish. But still pretty happy with that. I mean, to hit 4:30 at a double. Lowest body weight I've been at. As you heard me talking to my boy, I'm about like 186 right now. That's a really good sign. So, gonna take a 3x7. Gonna do the quick calculations to see where you should be at. It should be like a 3x7 at 7. So we're thinking like 74%. So probably like 340-ish type of deal. Do 3 sets there, call it a day, and then we'll get some accessories and head on home. But yeah, man, it's almost game day. We're looking good, feeling good, do what it do. We are done. Quick close grip after this. One quick accessory, probably some type of row. And we out of here, baby. We out of here. done, ladies and gentlemen.
Check accessory. Get on out of here. Efficient. We're efficient. 4 weeks out. Let's go.
All right, so now we have a 3x12 at 7 for some lateral raises. Real quick, real smooth, in and out day, and we're done for it. So 4 weeks out, 3 and some change, really. Really efficient workout, really quick. Get in, get out, get home, recover, get to sleep. This is it, the prep is over. It's almost game time. Let's get it. And we're done, baby. Workout done, bench session, 27 days, Sheffield, UK. Let's get it, baby. See y'all next week. As promised, I was gonna show you what's in the Sheffield 2023 athlete box. Super exciting stuff here. Let's open this bad boy up. We have the official inaugural Sheffield 2023 shirt. Super dope. You can catch it online as well. If you go to SBD.com, get yourself your own. And then we have our athlete itinerary. So this also tells me what I'm gonna be doing for that entire week leading up to Sheffield. So open it up. Just gives a quick breakdown of what Sheffield is, all of that. This is super dope. This is the arena that we will be competing in Sheffield, UK. Super dope. You can see there's tons and tons of stands, loads of people watching live, which would be so cool. These are the cash prize payouts. First, second, third, what you win for breaking records, etc. So a lot of money on the line, a lot of things at stake here. And this right here, this is my favorite page right here. It's always cool to see yourself amongst a lot of other great lifters across the world. And to think, what, in 4 short years, I'm gonna be a part of the first biggest competition in powerlifting history. It's super humbling. I'm super appreciative for the opportunity. I'm not taking it for granted. It's just super exciting. Like I remember opening up this box. I did open it up earlier. This is the first time I've seen it. But I remember seeing this and just like, you just have a wave of emotion coming too. Just see all that hard work come to fruition. So that's super dope. This is the location of Sheffield where we're gonna be at. I think this is the banquet hall where we're gonna have like the award ceremony afterwards. And yeah, that's pretty much it, right? This is the itinerary where we're gonna be doing photo shoots, etc., prior to it all. And so, yeah, that's in the secret athlete box for Sheffield. Sheffield 2023 is gonna be a great show. Super excited. And hey, 27 more days-ish by the time that I'm filming this video. By the time you see it, it'll probably be like a couple weeks or so. It's almost game day, baby. That's it. Let's get it.